Okay, so now we have the parts in here. We're going to dimension them. We were given instructions that we want to dimension it with aligned dimensions and with datum dimensioning. Okay, so first of all, we're going to go to the annotate ribbon. In that annotate ribbon, when you want to use datum dimensioning, you actually are going to click on baseline. Okay, so baseline and datum dimensioning are the same thing. All right, so I'm going to use baseline. And I need to think for a moment how exactly I want to have things laid out. I don't want a dimension to hidden lines, and I want my dimensions to be attached to the view where I can see the feature best. All right, so I'm going to start back here and have this as my first datum. So I've clicked on baseline. This is going to be my first datum. I don't want to actually click on the end of it. I want to click on the line itself. So from there to there, to there. Okay, and I've intentionally skipped that hidden line. All right, then I go right mouse click continue, and it will give me some options. It says, do you want to do this business over here or do you want to do this business over here? So I'm going to start with just doing in the width direction, and you'll notice that as you kind of move things around, it will suggest a really nice spacing. Usually whatever inventor is suggesting is a good spacing. So I'm going to go with where it kind of shows me, yeah, let's do it right here, and I'm going to click on that. So I click there, and then one more step, hit create. Because if you go to create a new dimension without hitting create, it'll actually delete what you've just done. So make sure to do that final step and hit create. Okay, so I got my first few dimensions in. I've got my overall width. I don't need to repeat that. I know where this is located. So this line here, I've got that located. I need to know in the width direction, I need to know where this is. So I need one more dimension over here. I'm going to just go to my regular dimension here, and I'm going to kind of use that same baseline though, using that back surface, and I'm just going to say from here to here, I need one more dimension. Let's just put that in there so that we know where the this whole piece here is located. I hit OK. All right, before I go any further, I'm going to set things up so that my aligned dimensions will take care of themselves. Instead of putting in a bunch of unidirectional dimensions and then changing them to aligned, I'm going to make these aligned dimensions right now. Okay, so I'm going to click on this and I'm going to right mouse click on it and I'm going to say new dimension style and I'm going to name it aligned. Okay, so I right mouse clicked on one of them. I named it renamed it aligned. And then I go to text. So I have all of these little things that I can play around with. I go over to text. And then over here where it has orientation, this is where you can play around with exactly how things are going to look on the dimensions. And so if you go through these, you'll see that there's a bunch of different options. Your best bet for right now is going to be on this third box here. The inline vertical is going to meet our purposes probably best. I'm going to try to choose inline vertical. I believe that the Project Lead the Way instructions suggest that you use this inline aligned, but I was finding that that was doing weird things. So you can choose that as well. You can choose them both. That's fine. So you've changed up this dimension style a little bit, and going forward, you're going to dig through this more and find that there's lots of cool stuff you can do. We renamed it aligned, and we hit OK. All right. So it doesn't show anything here because that is a horizontal dimension, but let's see what happens when we go to baseline and we create a baseline dimension on this top view because it shows the contours really nicely. So on this top view, I'll start with this line, then go to this line, and this one, and this one. So all of those lines there. Hit right mouse, click continue. So I'm done selecting lines. Now let's start putting the actual dimension together. And click to place it, and then right mouse, click create. The problem is those didn't become the aligned dimensions. I'm going to select them. Right mouse click on them and general dimension type. No, what's it doing here? Okay, let's try this again. How about new dimension style? And then we choose the aligned and we change them all to the aligned. So maybe I should have just done it after the fact. So that's what an aligned dimension looks like. It's aligned with the general direction of the feature. Okay, I have a bunch more to put in. Let me put them in a little bit more quickly. I'm going to go back to baseline and I'm going to say from this surface here to here and to here. I need to identify where those two features are located. However, I don't want another depth dimension because I have a depth dimension right here, right? I know that the depth is 1.25. So I just need to kind of figure out where those pieces are. So I hit continue and put this up here, allow Inventor to help me place it in a nice location. Click to place it and right mouse click create. All right, a little bit more that I need to mention. How about in the height direction? Go to baseline, go from the bottom to here and to here. Right mouse click continue and let's put those right there and hit create. So the problem here is that once again, they're not aligned. I'll select them. I'll go to, let's get out of whatever it's trying to do here. Right mouse click and why won't it let me change the dimension time? Let's do it one at a time. How about edit dimension style and I'll choose this align. So it's showing up a little bit different here. Save and close. Oops. I think I just messed something up. How about new dimension style? Choose aligned and see if that. Oh, there you go. Okay, click on it and right mouse click new dimension style. Choose aligned or whatever you called your new dimension style. There you go. And then I still have to dimension this feature here. So if you look through here, I think I've got everything covered except for that last one. So that feature here, I'm just going to put a basic dimension on. And I'll say from there to there, we'll make that one. And you can actually change it to align from here. So hit OK, and we need to hit Escape to stop it from trying to make new dimensions. And click on the dimension, right mouse click, new dimension style, hit aligned, and they are all aligned. Okay, there you go. Maybe not the most efficient way to make that, but that is your drawing with all the dimensions that are using datum dimensioning and they are aligned.